right guys, this is the Free Spirit. It's the top of the range, EIS 11 foot S model. I'm just comparing these two rods today, the IS and the CTX, being that the CTX is half the price of the IS. Is it worth it, the extra money? So we're about to find out. I've had a few fish on them already, so I'll just see if I can get a fish on and show you the action of the rods. Expecting that, to be honest. Normally if it had gone within 5 seconds it don't go. Nice action though, this IS, real nice, just feels better in your hand than the CTX. It's a lot lighter in your hand, just, you could tell the quality, you know, it just feels better. A gold spot. Noisy. Say about £5. Did feel nice, to be honest, on that rod. Real nice. Nice through action. Is it worth the extra money? It's just, it's double the price of the CTX. It's 240 quid's a lot of money for a rod 8. But it does feel nice. I like the angle on it. It seems to fit nice around the palm of your hand.
Action now.
slapping on the pole I worked today. I hate coming to the noise. Beautiful action now, most through action. I mean, being soft, I dare say you can get away with loads of lines. I mean, I'm on 6 pound today. Power micron matrix and an 019 up to a 14 kkh. The action's lovely, look. Real nice. Oh, another ghosty. To that guys, nice. So that's a good £7 or so. I really don't think they're coming into pole range either. I've had one on the pole, but they seem to be further out there by the rope. About 2.5 foot. That's beautiful though, this rod. I'm only on an 8 gram pellet waggler. All the rubbish down there. Straighten the hook actually, look. Straighten it out. And that's a KKH, Preston. They're like really powerful hooks, are they? And you straighten that out. Really well, this rod. I think that's about. Oh, Jesus! Snap me. Took a lot. that's what I call a bite. It snapped a lot, I think. Yeah, took the float and everything. Yeah, completely gone. That was a good start, wasn't it? action on this rod though. Beautiful. Just feels better in your hand. Completely better. Keep them pellets going in. About six to eight a time, and then just cast over the top. So we've got plenty of power. This CTX rod, lots of casting power. I mean, I'm having to really blast it out there. Broke me that one. That was a big fish. Didn't stop it. I had to stop it because it was going for the rope. I bet it's broke me that one. Yeah, snapped me, look. Well, was our 19, that was as well. To the action on that, definitely stiffer rod than the OS. Tie so much of a through action. A lot more power in the bud section in this rod. It's probably why you don't feel some noise, sort of thing. This rod's probably better with really heavy pellet wagglers and look really long distance chucks. I mean, it's high over powerful, this is still bending nice. You can feel it though, it's a lot stiffer. Chunky fish. Put him back, he's about 6 pound, 6-7 pound. But definitely a stiffer rod than the OS, the CTXs. You don't feel there's noise either. What I don't like about it is the angle, don't feel nowhere near as nice, it's a lot chunkier. And it's pretty weighty as well, the rod, compared to the OS. But I suppose that's why you're paying the extra £150 or so for a bit of finesse.